Good morning. Let us discuss today about nuclear chemistry or nuclear physics or radioactivity. This subject is common to both physics and chemistry major. We will discuss first isotopes, isobars, isotones. What are isotopes? Isotopes have the same atomic number but different mass number. They belong to same element, for example hydrogen, deuterium, tritium, etc. Whereas isobars have same mass number but different atomic number, okay. Whereas isotones have same mass, same number of neutrons but different elements. Okay, now let us go to radius of the nucleus. The radius of the nucleus, the entire mass of the nucleus is concentrated in the nucleus, okay? Because the protons and neutrons are much heavier than electron. The radius of the nucleus is of the order of 10^-15 meter, whereas the radius of the atom is in the order of 10^-10 meter, okay? For example, 10^5 times smaller, the nucleus is smaller. They may ask question like that. Okay, now how the radius of the nucleus is determined? The distance of the closest approach of the alpha particle to the nucleus. For example, this is a nucleus, this is your alpha particle. When it approaches, okay, the closest approach, you can come here, you can come here, come here, it can come up to this distance. It cannot go, this is the closest distance of approach of alpha particle to the nucleus, gives the measure of the radius of the nucleus. The radius of the nucleus is directly proportional to the mass number to the power 1/3. Therefore, the radius is equal to r0 a power 1/3, where r0 is a constant of proportionality. It is roughly equal to 1.3 fermion. Okay. Next, let us nuclear Coulombic energy barrier. Okay, well, how it is? Nuclear Coulombic energy barrier is calculated. E is equal to Ze1 into Ze2, charge on the, for example, charge on the nucleus 1 and alpha particle, and the charge on the nucleus Ze2 is the charge on the nucleus, atomic nucleus, E2 divided by 4π ε0 d. D is the distance between the two nuclei at the closest distance approach. Therefore, D equal to radius of the alpha particle, here this is alpha particle, plus radius of the nucleus, atomic nucleus. We can calculate the radius by using this formula. Therefore, we can calculate the, you know the Z, for example, alpha particle, you know the Z, E vary, Z1, for alpha particle, Z1 is 2, and Z2 is the atomic number of the nucleus, electronic charge, we know. Charge on the electron square divided by 4π ε0. ε0 is the permittivity of the free space, distance, radius, sum of the radius of the nucleus 1 and nucleus 2 at the closest distance of approach. The radius is calculated by the above formula. So there were many problems asked on this. Okay, now one atomic mass unit is equal to how many million electron volt. That is 931 milli electron volt. What is one atomic mass unit? It is nothing but 1/12 of mass of carbon 612 standard isotope. That is equal to 1.6 mass of the isotope divided by N0. Okay, mass of the isotope divided by N0. N0 is the Avogadro number. It will give 1.66 × 10^-27 kg. Next, E is equal to mc square. Therefore, mass of the mass, you know, c is the velocity of light, 3 × 10^8 meter per second, and then 1 electron volt equal to 1.6 × 10^-90 joule. Okay, using the formula, 1 joule, for example, 1 joule equal to 1 electron volt divided by 1.6 × 10^-19, we can calculate one atomic mass unit equal to 931 million electron volt. Million means 10^6 electron volt. 10^6. Okay, now let us see what is binding energy. Binding energy, for example, when a nucleus is formed, nucleus nucleus consists of protons and neutrons. When a nucleus is formed from the protons and the neutrons, okay, the mass is lost. The mass, for example, the mass of the nucleus is this. Mass of the nucleus, mass of the observed nucleus is this. We can calculate the mass of the nucleus by using the formula, that is Z atomic number into mass of the proton, okay, plus number of neutron, because number of neutrons are present, into mass of the neutron minus mass of the nucleus into C square, that is called binding energy. Binding energy, that is the delta M, this is nothing but delta M. This is the mass lost during the formation of the mass of the atom, mass of the nucleus. Mass of the nucleus is this is the mass lost. Okay, now binding energy per nucleon. It can be calculated by binding energy divided by mass number of the nuclei. Okay, number of nucleons, or we can say mass number equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Therefore, binding energy per nucleon gives the relative stability of the atom, relative stability of the nucleus, or relative stability of the nuclei. For example, let us draw a plot binding energy by binding energy per nucleon versus increase in atomic number. As you see, with increase in atomic number, there is an increase in the binding energy per nucleon, and it reaches maximum at iron 56. With the binding energy per nucleon is 8.8 million electron volt. This is the most stablest atom. A question may be asked, what is the most stable atom? Therefore, the most stable atom is iron 56, because it has got the highest binding energy per nucleon. Okay, 8.8 million electron volt. As you see, in the beginning, after 120 mass number, the binding energy per nucleon value decreases. Okay, similarly, if you see lighter nuclei have lower binding energy per nucleon, and similarly heavier nuclei also have lower binding energy per nucleon. That means they are unstable. More the binding energy per nucleon, more stable. Okay, so lighter nuclei and heavier nuclei are unstable, and therefore they undergo, either lighter nuclei undergo fusion and heavier nuclei undergo fission to form the most stable nuclei, iron. Okay, radioactivity. So heavier nuclei, they are radioactive. Heavier nuclei is radioactive, or radioactive because of unstable nuclei, as calculated from binding energy per nuclei. Okay, radioactivity is a spontaneous process, not affected by chemical reactions. Are affected by light, temperature, pressure, magnetic field, electric field, whereas nuclear reaction, especially radioactivity, is spontaneous, not affected by temperature, external agent, pressure, magnetic field, electric field, etc. Next, Soddy-Fajon displacement law. What is this nuclear displacement law? When alpha particle is emitted, for example, when alpha particle is emitted by the parent nuclei, the daughter nuclei will have two atomic number less, and mass number is decreased by 4 units. Therefore, the daughter element will shift group and position by 2 to the left of the periodic table. For example, if the parent element is fourth group, then the daughter element will be second group, because it will shift left in the periodic table, group numbers. For example, the parent element is group number 5, then the daughter element will be group number 3. Okay. Now, when a beta particle is emitted, because the beta particle does not have any mass, okay, whereas alpha particle have mass number 4, topic number 2. Here, therefore, because of the emission of beta particle, the atomic number increases by 1, therefore, it will, the daughter element or not element will shift one position right, in the periodic table. Therefore, the for example, if the parent nuclei is group 4, then the daughter, element formed is group 5. Okay, whereas Ross number there is no change. In the case of gamma rays, in case of gamma rays, it is an electromagnetic high energy radiation. It does not have any mass as well as it does not have any charge. Therefore, there is no change when gamma rays are emitted. There will be no change in the daughter nuclei or parent nuclei. Okay. Now, another important question often asked in JEE, JAM, NEET, GATE, even how many alpha and beta particles are emitted? For example, in the uranium-238 is converted into lead-214 N2 atomic number. Okay, there is a simple formula: N alpha equal to number of alpha particles emitted equal to loss of mass. Mass number, loss of mass equal to 238 minus 214 divided by 4 equal to 6. Therefore, the number of alpha particle emitted is 6. Okay. Next, let us calculate number of beta particle. Number of beta particle emitted is equal to, there is a simple formula, 2 into number of alpha particle minus atomic number of the parent element minus atomic number of the daughter element. Okay. When you calculate, you can also, you need not apply this formula. You can calculate on your own. For example, when alpha particle is emitted, as you see, you think about it, okay, instead of using this formula. When alpha particle is emitted, only the mass number changes. Mass number changes by 4. Okay, for each alpha particle, the mass number decreases by 4. Therefore, if you subtract 238 minus 2, for beta particle, there is no mass change. Okay, therefore, 238 minus 214 divided by 4, for each alpha particle 4, the decrease in mass number is 4, therefore it will give. And similarly, the number of beta particle can be calculated, how much, for example, for alpha particle, how, for 6 alpha particles are emitted, therefore 12, the atomic number should have been decreased by 12, whereas it is decreased by 10 only, 92 by 10. Therefore, 2 beta particles are emitted. So, we can use either this formula or your logic or your reasoning to calculate how many alpha particles and beta particles are emitted. We will continue further and complete the radioactivity. Thank you.